Hello everyone. There is a beautiful saying in English. Life is not about finding yourself. Life is about creating yourself. Welcome to online class, Computer Science. The new chapter that we are going to start today is Logic Gates. Logic Gate is continuation of the Boolean algebra. In Boolean algebra, we have dealt with variables having only two values, 0 and 1. So that algebra which deals with 0 and 1 is called as Boolean algebra. So today we are going to continue with the same concept, but this is the next chapter, that's logic gate. Now the question is, what is a logic gate? Logic gate is an electronic circuit. It's an electronic circuit. Electronic circuit which operates on one or more input signals and produces a single output. In the previous class, in the previous chapter, that is Boolean algebra, we have seen the operators, which are those AND, OR, and NOT. Here also we are going to talk about the same. Mainly, when we talk about the gate, the definition says that it's an electronic circuit which operates on one or more input signals and produces a single output, or single output signal we can write. So rule here says that when we are going to give the input, whatever we are going to give is called input, right? What comes as the output? There is the rule here. When we input, we can have one or more. In some of the gates, we will be having only one input. In some of the gates, we can have two, or more than two inputs we can have. But whatever may be the number of inputs, but when we talk about the output, there will be only one output signal. That is about the definition of the gate or a logic gate. Now, moving further, logic gates are divided into two groups or two categories. One is basic gates. Second one is derived gates. In Boolean algebra, already we have seen some of the operators. So using those operators, now we are going to build the gates. Which are the operators that we have seen in Boolean algebra? They are NOT, OR, and AND. Right? So when we talk about basic gates, we have NOT gate, OR gate, and AND gate. So NOT gate, OR gate, and AND gate. It comes under basic gates. Now using these basic gates, we can derive derived gates, or we can have this derived gates. Which are those? We have NAND, NOR, XOR, and XNOR. So from the derived gates, we can have these four. Now one by one we shall see. Coming to the basic gates, first we shall have not gate. When we talk about the not gate, what's the not gate? Not gate is a gate which will take only one input signal and gives single output. Of course, whenever we are talking about the gates, it will give only one output signal. That is the definition of the gate. Here, how many inputs does it take? It will take only one input signal. When we write the truth table, already we have seen about the NOT operator. We shall write the same. Suppose we have, see, anyhow we are talking about gate. So it is a part of the Boolean algebra here. That's why whenever we talk about a particular variable, if the variable is x, how many values this x can have? It can have only two values, which are those 0 and 1. No other value is possible because binary 0 and 1, only two values. That's why when we write the possibilities of x, these are the two values. We shall write a truth table here for the NOT gate. So if the variable is x, its output is x naught or x bar or x complement. This is also called as inverter. Inverter in the sense, whatever we are going to feed, that will be complemented. It inverts that. So which are the values that we can have? They are 0 and 1. Only two values are possible. And we know that it takes only one input, right? One input. Of course, produces single output. This is true in all the cases. But what about the input? Here there is a condition that NOT gate should have only one input. It operates on only one input. So one input x. We are not going to write x and y. Only one x or e, whatever it is. But only one. 0 and 1. How it works? It inverts, it complements. Since we have only two values, 0 and 1, what is the complement of 0? That's 1. What is the complement of 1? That is 0. So this is the truth table. This 0 can be written as low also, and 1 can be written as high. Or say 0 can be written as low, or it can also be written as false. If 0 is written as low, how the 1 could be written? This could be written as high. If 0 can be written as false, how we can write 1? It can be written as true. So these are the different notations that we can have. 0, low or false, 1, high or true, one and the same. Usually when we write the truth table, we will write it with respect to 0 and 1. Now, we have written the truth table. Now we have to write the symbol for that. Symbol is a triangle. Triangle like this. And a bubble in front of that. So it shows the input. It shows the output. So input, this is the input, this is the output. So if the input is x, if the input is x, x can have the value 0 or 1, output will be x bar. If x is equal to 0, x bar will be 1. If x is equal to 1, x bar will be 0. That is about the NOT gate. So NOT gate always inverts the input signal. It will have only one input and produces single output. Always it complements the input. That's about the NOT gate. The next one. Next one is AND gate. AND gate. When we write the AND gate, first we shall write the truth table. So in AND gate, we will have two or more input signals. That's why we shall write X and Y. And the symbol that we are going to operate is X plus Y, we have seen in the Boolean algebra. So when we are going to, it is X dot Y. X dot Y, plus is for OR. For AND gate, it is dot X into Y, X dot Y. So here, the different values that we can have, once again, X is equal to, X can have 0 and 1. Y can have, again, 0 or 1. Possibilities, in order to have the AND gate, we should have at least two inputs. In case of NOT, we have seen that, we can have only one input, right? But in case of AND, we should have at least two inputs. We can have more than two. It's possible. But minimum condition is two variables. That's why when we write the X, X variable can have 0 or 1, right? Only two possibilities. Again, Y. Y can have only two values, 0 or 1. So different combinations we can have, right? How to write? See, X value can be 0. Y can be 0, one possibility with respect to X. X is equal to 0. What is the other possibility? X can be 0, X can be 0, Y can be 1. Okay, we have done with X is equal to 0. Next one, 1. X can be 1, Y can be 0. X can be 1 and Y can be 1. These are the different possibilities with X and Y having the value 0 and 1. How to represent the operator? Operator is dot. So we will write X dot Y. Here it's just like the multiplication, but it's not the multiplication. We call it as logical multiplication. Here we call it as logical multiplication. Here it says that whenever any one of the value is 0 or the both the values are 0, the output will be 0. We will follow the same rule in multiplication also. Here also we are following, it is similar to that, but logical multiplication is not equal to the multiplication. There is a small difference. I would like to repeat. Whenever we have any one of the input value as 0, the output will be 0. In this case, 0 and 0, anyhow both the values are 0, obviously the output will be 0. Next one will be 0 and 1, there is a 0 here, so again it will be 0. 1 and 0, again there is a 0, it is 0. And the last one, 1 and 1, so both the values are 1, so the answer will be 1. So by looking at the table, this is the truth table. Usually one 2 mark question will be asked, write the truth table for a particular gate. When we observe the truth table, we can note that only for this particular combination 1 and 1, the answer will be 1. That means if both the values, one is high, right? 1 is high, 0 is low. So when both the values are high or when both the values are 1, the output of AND gate will be 1, otherwise it will be 0. So here 2 or more, this is about input. What about the output? Always only one output. What we have seen, when both the input values are high, the output value will be high. Otherwise, it will be low, or the output value will be zero. Now the symbol representation, using the symbol, which is the symbol here? Symbol is, this is the symbol, that is something like D. How many inputs? In this case, 2 inputs and single output. Which are the values that we are going to input? X and Y. What about the output? Output will be, we can write F is equal to X into X dot Y. F is function, or what is the output? What will be output? That is X dot Y. So this is the table for 2 input. This is the symbol for 2 input and gate. Now the question is, can't we have 3 inputs? Of course we can have. How to represent 3 inputs and gate? Easy, already we have seen. Even in first year, we have written binary equivalents from 0 to 7, right? That is, see, for example, when we have 3 input, we shall take it as A, B and C. So ABC, in the sense, see here, let us try to understand. A can have 0 or 1, B can have the input 0 or 1, C also can, we can have 0 or 1. So 3 combinations we should have, isn't it? That's why when we write the table here, it becomes somewhat lengthy. A, B, C. In case of 2 inputs, we have written A dot B. Here we have 3. So what we need to write? A dot B dot C. Right? So we shall write from 0, 0, 0, because 3 inputs are there. Next one will be 0, 0, 1. 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0. Now the same thing will get repeated, by changing this 0 to 1. So after 0, 0, what we had? 0, 1, right? So 1, 0, 1, after that 1, 1, 0, then 1, 1 and 1. In 2 input AND gate, we have seen, if any one of the value is 0, the output will be 0. In this case, how many inputs do we have? We have 3 inputs. That's why, if any one of the value is 0, the output will be 0. We need not multiply all the values. Just examine the input values. If any one of the value, any one of the input, these 3 are inputs, right? These 3 are inputs, A, B and C. If any one of the input value is 0, the output will be 0. So here there is 0, so it will be 0. In these first 4 combinations, A is 0, so directly we can write it is 0. In the next value, A is 1, it's okay. But what about these B and C? Here there are 2 zeros, so 0. Here there is 1 0, 0. Here this value is 0, so 0. Here all inputs are 1, that's why the output will be 1. Logic symbol, or symbolic representation of AND gate. the gate. How many inputs? Three inputs, A, B and C. A, B and C. Output function F is equal to X into, it's not X here, it is A. So A into B into C. A dot B dot C. That's about AND gate. So out of 8 combinations, only for the last combination it is 1, that is 1, 1 and 1. In this case it is 1. For all other combinations the output will be 0. That's about AND gate. This is 3 input AND gate. We shall see the other basic gate, that is OR gate. The OR gate. In case of OR gate, again we should have at least 2 input values. We shall write the table for the OR gate. Let us have 2 inputs as A and B. So A or X and Y, one and the same. If it is X and Y, the combinations we know 0, 0, only 2 inputs here. At least 2 inputs 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. And 1 and 1. The symbol, the operator used for OR gate is plus, we know that. For AND gate it's dot, for OR gate it's plus, for NOT gate it's bar. So X plus Y. In case of AND, if both the values are 1 then output will be 1. If any one of the value is 0, the output will be 0. But in case of OR, if any one of the value is 1 or both the values are 1, the output will be 1. So if any one of the value is 1, the output will be 1. 0, 0, both the values are 0. 0, 1, there is 1. 1, 0, there is 1. 1 and 1, both the values are 1, so it is 1. So 0, 1, 1 and 1. So by looking at this particular truth table, what we have seen or what we have observed, only for 0 and 0 the output will be 0. For all other values, for all other combinations, it's a 1. The symbol or representation, logic symbol, will be a curved line here. It's not straight. In case of AND, it was straight, and here also somewhat curved. This is the symbol. Now the input X, Y. What about the output? F is equal to X plus Y. It is about 2 input OR gate. Similarly, we can have 3 input OR gate. Already we have seen. Let us write X, Y, Z or ABC. Since it is a table, let us write it in the form of a table always. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, and last one, 1, 1, and 1. What about the output? Output will be, we can write F is equal to f is equal to x plus y plus z. X plus y plus z. What we have observed in two input OR gate, if any one of the value is 1, the output will be 1. Let us follow the same rule here also. In all the combinations, except for the first combination, all three values are 1. Right? So here we don't have any value as 1. Obviously, it will be 0. There should be at least one input as 1 in order to get the output as 1. In all other combinations, so here there is 1, there is 1, here 1 is there, 1 is there, 1 is there, here there are 1s, here all three values are 1. That's why except for this particular combination, it will be 1. So only for the combination 000, that is for 3 input OR gate, the except for the combination 000, for all other combinations the output will be 1. This is about 3 input OR gate truth table. When we talk about the symbol, now instead of 2 we have 3. We need to write the same curve line. What curve line? How many inputs now? 3 input. 3 input, which are those? X, Y, Z. Output will be F is equal to X plus Y plus Z. Remember, for the exams, either they will ask the truth table, it may be about any of the logic gates, it may be AND or NOT, or these three are basic gates, or truth table of derived gates. Then also we need to remember the symbol. Symbol may be asked for 1 mark. Many times they have asked it for 1 mark. So just now we have seen the basic gates, of course, which was covered under Boolean algebra also, but there we didn't have the symbol. It was only for the operator. Now coming to the derived gates. Derived gates. First one we shall take NAND. What's a NAND gate? NAND gate, see here it says that derived gate. We are deriving this particular gate using the basic gates. Which are the basic gates? Basic gates are NOT, AND, and OR. Right? So NAND is the combination of AND plus NOT. So in this particular NAND gate, we have two gates, two basic gates. Which are those? AND gate, and also we have NOT gate. When we write the symbol of NAND gate, to the table later we shall write. First we shall talk about the working of this NAND gate. NAND gate, the symbol will be, see, AND we have. AND is what? AND is this one. AND is something like a D. We shall talk about two inputs to understand it easily. So this will be the AND, right? So it will give an output. Then what next we shall have? This is NOT gate. NOT gate is represented by what? A triangle, inverted triangle, with a bubble in front of that is NOT gate. So it will take single output, sorry, it will take single input and gives single output. One input, one output. At least two inputs and single output. So it is a combination of AND and NOT. In this order itself we have to write. We can't write NOT and AND. No. First AND, then whatever output of AND we got, NOT that. That means, this is the combination of two, right? So working will be, first it will be AND. Here we will get the output. Whatever output we got, not that. This is the working of that. Right? But instead of writing this, there is a separate representation for that, or there is a symbol for that. That will be, write this particular symbol of and from this, don't try this triangle, take only this particular bubble, so represent that bubble in front of and. Now it becomes NAND. So this is the symbol for NAND. Even for the NAND, at least two inputs should be there, and then output will be there. So how it will work? We will input two values, at least two values. It will be ANDed, ANDed in the sense using AND gate, that particular ANDing operation will be done. Whatever output we got from that ANDing, that will be complemented here. That means whatever output of AND we got, its answer will get complemented. We shall try to understand that with the help of a truth table now. Hope this is understood here. So if it is A, this is B. Here what we will get, that will be A dot B, A dot B, multiplication, logical multiplication. Here this will be A dot B, whatever answer we got, that will be complemented. So this will be A, this will be B, F is equal to A into B complement. It will be easy for us to understand it with the help of a truth table. Now, we shall write it as A, B. Instead of directly writing A into B complement, we shall write A into B first, A into B first. That is AND. Then we shall write A into B complement. It will be easy for us to understand the working of NAND gate. So, in this case, the combinations we know 0, 0, right? 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. We also know that how the AND gate will work. Only for this particular combination, it will be 1. For all other combinations, it will be 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. Because in case of AND gate, in order to have the output as 1, both the values should be 1. If any one of the value will be 0, the output will be 0. Now coming to the NAND gate. NAND gate is the complement, say, A into B whole complement. It's not A complement into B complement. There is a difference. Try to understand. A into B complement and A complement and B complement, there is a difference. It's not the same. Here we are taking the AND first, whatever AND we got, then we complement it. In this case, complement A, complement B, then AND it. There is a difference. So suppose we have, see for example, 0 and 0 for this particular combination, A into B, 0 dot B, 0 dot 0, the answer will be 0. 0 dot 0, the answer will be 0, that 0 will be complemented, right? In this case, 0 complement, that will be 1. B, that also be 0, 0 complement, that will be 1. So, 1 dot 1. So, that's why, be careful. Now, in this case, A dot B whole complement, that means whatever answer we got after ANDing this, it has to be complemented. So 0 complement, its complement will be 1, 0 complement will be 1, 0 complement will be 1, 1 complement will be 0. That's about 2 input AND gate. Can we have 3 input AND gate? Of course, we can have. How it will be? A, B, C, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1 1 and 1, A dot B dot C. Only for this particular combination, that is 1 1 and 1, we have it as 1. For all other combinations it will be 0, we know that, because if one of the value is 0, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 and 8. What about the symbol A dot B dot C whole complement? That's the NAND of 3 input. What will be the answer? Everywhere it is 0, right? Except the last one. So for all zeros, the complement will be 1. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. And for the last one, it is 0. 6, 7, and 1. That is, this is for this one, this is for this one, this is for this one, this is for this one. Only for this one, it is 0. So it is about 3 input NAND gate. 3 input NAND gate will be written as, symbolically, this is AND, this is NAND. Now 3 input A, B and C, A, B and C. This will be F is equal to A dot B dot C whole complement. That's about NAND gate. Next one will be a NOR gate. We shall see the NOR gate in the next class. Okay, thank you.